Joy Fitness 43, and this morning we're going to do a standing ab workout. So for this workout, you're going to need two light weights. So I have just a couple 2-pound weights for this workout. So you can use two light weights, or you can do like one medium light weight, like a 5-pound weight. So I advise against using heavier weights just because we really want to concentrate on the movement itself. There are going to be a couple movements that are over the head, and so we just want to really think about what we're doing during this workout, and then after you know the movements, you can go up in weight maybe the next time that you do it. So we're going to do two workouts. One's going to be with weight, and then the next one's going to be without any weight at all. Alrighty, so let's start up with our warm-up. Okay, so what's nice about these workouts is that even though we're targeting our abs, I want you to think about it as more being our core, the powerhouse of our body that keeps us upright. So we kind of use our whole body to do each of the ab exercises. So that's why I want you to, instead of isolating just like the upper abs or the lower abs or your obliques or your lower back, we're going to you're gonna be using your legs and your arms to do functional fitness moves, because you have to use your core, you know, like from here to here, in order to get things done. Say, bending down and picking up something, or reaching to get something. And that's, you know, when that's strong, that's what keeps you upright and keeps you balanced. So I just want you to think about that as we're doing each move, okay? So, there we go. That's what I wanted to do. So, each movement is going to help you to whittle away your waistline, but it's also going to help you to have better posture and better balance and a stronger overall body. So we'll just keep doing our warm up. And then our second set of exercises will be a little bit more familiar moves that are non-weighted exercises that will be standing. So always good to know, especially for people that don't want to get down on the floor when we're doing ab exercises. But you always have that, you know, bed option, or perhaps discovered the ottoman or coffee table the other day and thought, oh, I can do my ab exercises here. So you don't actually have to get on the floor, but you're still in that position where you're lying down. So you can still do them, because all of them have their own benefits. That's why we do so many different kinds, right? Variety is the spice of life, and every exercise has its own benefit for you. Okay, now let's reach back. Good. Really trying to bend the knees just a little bit. Let that lower back. Shake it out. Perfect. Okay, so we're going to get ready to do our first workout. Get this up here. I'm going to use my two little weights to start with. So if you don't have little weights, you can also use just like a broom handle. Just make sure you don't have anything in your way so that you don't hit anything from side to side. So we're going to start with a chop. So I'm just going to hold my weights together like this. So it's a big chop. So we're going to go all the way up, and we're going to pivot all the way down to this foot and come all the way up. So if you can't pivot that low because of your knees, you can go down to your knee. But I want you to remember that we're turning when we go down, and then we're going to come all the way back up again, okay? So we're going to start with that one. And then the next ones don't take as much movement as that. But we're going to work for 50 seconds, and we're going to transition for 10. So there's plenty of time to do each movement. They're not super fast. So I want you to think about each movement as you're doing them. And we have plenty of time to do them. We're going to go through each, you know, side of our body twice. Big movement. Stretch up. Don't give me partially of the way up. Really stretch back up. And come all the way back down. Go as far as you can. Okay? So you can see how this is going to work with your entire body. Not just that waistline. Pivot. Okay, so for this next one, we're going to raise our arms up, and we're going to take a step with that front leg. So I'm going to use my left leg, and it's just a little step forward, and there's a little arch in the back, and you're pushing those arms back. Now, if this movement hurts to keep going up and down, you can leave your arms up and just go this little movement. So whichever is best for you. It's that little pushback is going to get up through those abs. Alright, so now we're going to take a little step to the side. I'm going to use that same leg. Okay, my arms are up. I'm going to take my arms to the opposite side that I step. Side bend there. Okay, so now we're going to rest those arms. We're going to do a front step, and we're just going to rotate. This one we've done before. So front step, rotation, let's keep that head in line with our movement, okay? You know what we're doing. You don't have to watch anymore. It's not a huge front step either. Don't feel like you have to make this giant lunge because we're not working the leg. We're working the waistline. Good. All right, so this next one, we're gonna do that same side, and we're gonna take a step back, and we're gonna rotate. Okay, so step back. Rotate back and then come forward. So it's a little bit deeper. Gotta be up on your game in that rotation, getting back. See how it gets that waistline just a little bit deeper. Like I said, you can use one weight for these, or a stick, or no weight at all for these. Okay, so now we're going to start over, and we're going to do the other side. So we're going to start with the chop. Okay, so we go up, and we pivot down. Whoop. There we go. I had to get my pivot on there. Turning on the ball of my foot. Get that chop in there. Reaching up. Remember, you can just go to right here with your chop if you need to. Maybe on one side you can go down, the other side you can't. So the next one is our step forward with our arm swing up, or just that little press up, depending on what feels best to you. Remember, we got to press it back enough so that you get that little arc in the back. That's what's going to get the front of those abs. We're getting all of them lower and upper. And even your lower back. Just don't let those arms swing. Make sure you're bringing them up and down. Don't let momentum do it. Okay, so front step with the rotation. Oh, I'm sorry. We're going to do this one first. Okay, so we're going to go to the side with the side step out. Now it's the front step with the rotation. Okay. Definitely feel that. So we're using so much of our body. So remember, we're going to move that head with the rotation. Good morning.
Good morning.
Okay, we're going to continue with our next round. Sorry. I had a neighbor that wanted to mow, and I'm just trying to get out of the dust. Okay, so we're going to start the other side again. So grab those weights, and we're going to start with the wood chop. Okay, ready? Original side. Here we go. So we're going to step forward, and we're going to do those arms up. Then we're doing a little bit of a back bend. Not too far, and that's why we don't want those super heavy weights, because that would be an awful lot on our back. Remember, you can leave your arms up and just do a little press back. Every time, instead of using full momentum to get those arms back. Good. Keep going. Okay, so we're gonna have the arms up again, and we're gonna take a side step out. Arms are gonna go to the opposite side. Good. Try to keep that neck up. Don't let your chin bury into your chest. Shoulders burning. Okay, so this is the front step with the full rotation. We're going to take our head with it, okay? So up and rotate. Are you feeling it already? I'm feeling it. Do that core. I know tomorrow or by the end of the day, I'm going to go, whoa, I can definitely feel that. Walk after this for my finisher. Rotation. So I'm almost doing, 180 degree turn here. It's getting pretty far back there. And then doing that just a little extra rotation so I can feel it pretty good in those obliques. You gotta turn as far as you can. Out falling over, and then give it that little squidgy with that rotation, because that's what gets those muscles. Good, okay, so last set. We're gonna bring it up and we're gonna come all the way down in our nice full rotational chop. Remember, form before speed, before weight. Get that form as smooth as you can get it. Think, am I doing everything I can? Am I rotating that knee in, pivoting on that opposite foot, coming back up, extending those arms. Excellent, okay. Stepping forward, lifting the arms, or leaving the arms up and just doing that little press back. Okay, here we go. Get that little arch in the back. There we go, see that? Really pulling those abs in tight, pulling the belly button in to the spine. Here we go. I think I did them in the wrong order again, didn't I? No? We're gonna do that side step now. Okay, so now the side step. I think that was right. That and now the side step. And then we do the front step with the rotation. It's this one I keep forgetting. Almost there. Whew. Arms are tired. Okay, so front step with the rotation. Take that neck with you when you go. Okay, so up and rotate. Remember, it's not a big long lunge, it's a step forward. But it's a nice rotation. Try to get those weights maybe by the hip as you go around. Good. Try not to rest them on your body so that you can pivot that body around and not skim it along your body. Okay, last one. We're going to step back and then do that nice little rotation into the back. Okay, we're ready. This is the last one. good. Make sure that you get that little rotation at the back. You'll be able to feel it in those obliques as you get that little elbow round. Okay, so that's gonna be it. I had to restart the timer when we went around the corner. Alrighty, so that's all four rounds there. That's 20 minutes. Excellent. So get a drink of water. We'll take a little break. I'm gonna reset the timer. We're gonna put the weights down, make sure they're out of the way, and we'll do our 16-minute set. So our next one has four exercises, and we're gonna do them four times each again, okay? So we're gonna do a, we do a side lunge with a knee up to a side lunge and a squat. Then we change sides. Side lunge to a knee up to a side lunge and then a squat. And then we change sides, okay? So it gets that knee up. So that forcing movement helps work the oblique and the lower abs. Then we're gonna do a split squat. So we'll do a split squat. We'll do a full rotation. And then you can just step back or you can jump, either one, okay? And do a full rotation and then split. So you can either step, you know, forward or backward to get into that other leg being in front, either way, okay? Or you can just jump and then jump. It works either way. Okay, so then we're gonna go into a goddess crunch, and we've done these before, so it's just a sumo squat, as big as you can get it, okay? And then we're just gonna go back and forth, like that. And then our last one is an alternating knee, hand to foot. So it's the this, 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 this. Alrighty, so those are our four exercises. We're gonna do them each four the buzzer's done, okay? So we're gonna start with the side lunge knee up, side lunge squat, and we're just gonna go back and forth. All right, so pick a side. So I'm gonna start on this side. Side lunge knee up, side lunge, bring it in, squat. Okay. Side lunge knee up, side lunge, bring it in, squat. Side lunge knee up, side lunge, bring it in, squat. Side lunge knee up. Side lunge, bring it in, squat. Forgot the side lunge. Knee up. Side lunge, bring it in, squat. All these directions. Maybe I should stop talking about it and just do it, right? There we go. Keep going. Okay, so there's that first one. Okay, so now we're gonna do the split squat with the full rotation. So we'll start in the split squat, go down, and we'll do rotation, and switch, and switch, and switch, and switch. So it doesn't matter, you know, which way you rotate, because you're gonna do both sides. I usually like to go towards the leg that's in front first. There we go. Keep going. Almost there. Okay, so the next one is going to be the goddess crunch. So nice wide legs, as wide as you can get them. Squat down, fingertips behind the ear, roll the shoulders back. So if you can't touch elbow to thigh, just go up here and go side to side, okay? As good as you can get it. Don't worry about it. Try to get low in that squat, because that's gonna work at the lower back, which is part of your, what? lower. The lower I go, the closer I am to my legs. Woo. Okay, alternating knee, alternating foot. This one I kind of like because I'm upright, not in any weird positions. So, knee, foot, knee, foot, knee, foot. Now, if you can't get to the foot, just do the knee or do slap your shin or something. Whatever you can get to, slap out here. But it's a crossover. And again, we're using everything. We're using the back, upper back, shoulders to get this stuff done. Glutes, thighs, to do your abs, which is your core. This helps with balance. See, we're on one leg. So we're working the ankles. So, okay, that's round one. Let's do round two. Okay, so we're back to the side lunge. And we do it. Let's be good. Ready? Here we go. You know, by the time we get done, I'll get it smooth. Right now, it's like hit or miss. There we go. See? Last one. Okay, so split squat. So I'm going to do the step forward, step back one this time. Real keen on that jump up, jump back. So it's kind of fun. Still going towards the leg that's in front first. So with these, work a little bit faster. Make your heart go pitter-patter. Get your cardio in. Same as you're doing your abs. So you're doing like a full body exercise, targeting abs, but you're still using your legs, arms, bring your heart rate up, and you got us. Down, fingertips, roll the shoulders. Breathe, 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 breathe. That's it. You can slow it down if you want to. Don't let the elbows come forward though. Push it back. Work on that posture. Feel it in my lower back. Making my abs strong. Working the obliques. Feel it where I'm weak. Maybe taking that high knee up a little bit too, right? Okay. Alternate knee, alternate elbow. Elbow, foot. Right. Up here. This one's actually fun to do, so loving it. And I can usually talk and not mess up when I do this. You know how it is. I finally do it like 50 million times. You're like, oh, I can do it without having to think. Okay, so two more rounds. 16-minute one. Yeah, we're pretty good. A little stretch. Oh, look at that. See my set? But you didn't, did you? Okay. Gotta do this. Okay, so we're starting with the, oh yeah, side lunge. Side lunge. Neighbor's air conditioner. Does he have a lawnmower? Oops. Yep, it's morning here. Traffic everywhere. Okay, so split squat. You can jump if you want to. I'm refraining from jumping. Okay, so back. There, good job. Keep going. Woo. Try it this way. Woo. That one leg that you pivot on all the time really gets it, doesn't it? Okay, goddess. This is round three. Having a good time. So when you do the split squat, you have to remember that whatever leg you're pivoting on, you should change to the other leg the next time. Okay. Knee to elbow, hand to foot. Try to get that, if you can get that hand to your foot, try to get it a little bit higher each time you do it to really get it through that glute and to work those muscles in the front of your abs, okay? Good. Hip flexors are working hard here. Bringing that leg up. Got to pull the belly button in when you do this because you're also working your lower back a lot too. Got to protect that lower back. Okay, last round of everything. Okay, go to the side. I'll start this way. So, sweating on myself. It's not as bad today. Oh, because there's a breeze. The temperatures are supposed to be nice, but it's gonna get in the 90s. So it will heat up, but this evening should be lovely. Slow down, I can tell. Good. Okay. I'm gonna do this like that. I'm gonna go back and forth on it this time. Because I used that one last time. Too enthusiastic there. You have to stay. Don't get your feet too far apart. Don't think you have to step back real far. It's not. It's pretty close. So you can say balance. And don't sit behind you like a curtsy lunge, because that'll throw you off, like it did me. Okay, so goddess. Last time. Happy goddess, right? Nice and deep into that waistline. Now we're trying not to hunch over and go like this, okay? Or tall. So if you can only go like this and stay tall, then do that, okay? So don't try to hunch over in front to touch that elbow to the knee. You've got to stay upright. We want that spine to be going side to side, not front and twist. We already did some rotating movements. There's a difference between a rotation and a twist. We're avoiding the twist. We want a rotation. This is going to be a rotation for your spine. Rotate, rotate. Believe it or not, you're getting that little rotation here, just like you did when you're doing the split squat. Nice and high. A can-can dancer. Woo! That's it. Each one. Get it up there. Slow it down if you need to. So you can concentrate on balance. Now my supporting leg is usually always bent just a little bit. So I can make sure I have a little shock absorber in that knee. Okay? Done already. Listen to me. I talked and talked and talked. Okay, get a drink of water and we're going to cool down. Good. Wow. Alrighty. So you can pause me if you need to rest for a little bit more. Otherwise, let's start that cool down. Okay, so we're going to start with just dynamic for just a second. And I just want you to open the palms, bend the knees just a little bit. Let's rotate. Okay, let's go ahead and take it with the heel up. Let's slow it down. Chin is up, parallel with the floor. Don't drop your chin down to look at the ground, okay? And you don't need it up in the air looking at the sky either. We're just going to go back and forth. Okay, so now we're going to take a hand, we're going to reach back behind us, and we're going to put it in that back pocket. And you're going to look in that back pocket. So the opposite hand can come around and rest. And you're going to breathe, okay? Breathe. We're gonna let that heart rate come down. all the way down into that belly button, right? Okay, we're gonna turn around and go the other way. Nice rotation. Okay, we're letting our head follow our spine. So this functional fitness ab work, okay, core work, and ab work, all standing, learning new moves all the time. Okay, so we're going to bend over, but we're not going to stick our hip out, okay? We're just going to take our waistline to the side. We're going to try to stay up as high as, keep our legs in the same spot. We're not going to let that hip pop out. Okay, and we're not going to press against the knee. So if you need to keep that hand up here and bend the elbow, you can do that. Or it can come down here to the shin. But if you're at that awkward spot where it wants to rest on the knee, then you up here. Okay. Just really trying to get it through that side, the side of the lower back. Take it over. That's a little bit more. Feeling it. Good. Now we're gonna inhale, exhale. Ooh, let's bring it up. Continue to the other side. Same thing. Going to the side. So one side's not gonna feel the same as the other. You might feel looser in one side and less loose in the other. We gotta start over. Okay, less hip. More waistline. There we go. Okay, bring your arm over. It just kind of acts as a weight and it gives you more stretch. And I'm trying to reach, reaching to the other side. So it gives a little more pull. Good. Inhale, exhale. Let's bring it back up. Oh, nice. Okay, hands, lower back facing each other. Okay. And we're going to not push our hips out. We're just going to take back just a little bit. And that neck is going to follow the spine. So you're not going to tilt the head back. Excuse me. We're just going to let it follow the spine. So the head's going to go back, but you're not going to drop it. The hands support that lower back. So, you know, if you get a lower back ache from this, it's because your lower back is weak, and a lot of these exercises used your lower back, especially that first set that we did. Inhale, exhale. Okay, let's take it forward. So you're gonna stick the tush out. Okay, so we're gonna just push the tush out. We're gonna keep that head above your heart though, okay? So hopefully your heart rate is back down. So don't ever think that you have to do a bunch of cardio, you know? You have to go get on the elliptical for 30 minutes after you weightlift. If you're doing weightlifting right, your heart rate should come up because you're doing enough weight that your body has to work hard and raise your heart rate while you're lifting weights. That's how you get your cardio. And when you lift weights, your body is going to continue to burn calories when you're done lifting weights. When you're done with cardio, as soon as your heart rate goes down, you're going to stop burning those calories. Okay, round the back, check in the chin a little bit, come back up. Okay, let's roll the shoulders down and back. So remember that, lifting weights, you get more bang for your buck. When you do a ton of cardio, after about, anywhere from 2 to 20 minutes, depending on who you are and what you've eaten, what you're your diet is, your body's going to tap into your muscles for the nutrition that it needs to keep going, okay? The calories that it needs. So let's just go ahead and stretch those shoulders because we use those. So you think you're losing weight from fat, but you could be losing weight from eating your muscles away. So you have to be real careful about that. We need to keep muscle in order to burn more calories. Muscle burns more calories than fat does, right? So two people can weigh 132 pounds and look completely different. One can wear a size 4 at 132 pounds and the other one can wear a size 10 at 132 pounds. So it just depends on which one has more fat. And obviously the one that is in a size 10 is going to be the one that has more fat, because you're leaner when you have more muscle. Women cannot get big and bulky by lifting weights. Don't let anyone ever tell you that. You will get stronger. You will look sleeker, but you will not. And you might get more what they call cut. You know, you can see, ooh, look, you can see my bicep, you can see my shoulder, you can see the muscles in my legs, but you're not going to get big and bulky. It's impossible, okay? Unless you take supplements, which are usually illegal. And you're not going to do that, right? Okay, let's shake it out. Unless you want that kind of body. But I don't know how to get them, so you can't ask me. Alrighty, so we're all done stretching. Drink lots of water. Keep moving, because you might get a little sore in that body. Go for a walk. Walking is probably the best finisher for this workout, because you get that axial motion, right? And you have to use your arms. So you have to, you know, get this, you know, how they, this movement, and it makes your whole spine move. Walk with your arms, and it will help relieve any soreness a little bit more that you have from doing this workout. So enjoy your day. Have a great day. This is Joy from Enjoy Fitness 43, and I'll see you next time. Bye.